Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Join me today. We're going to talk about treatments for the all common question, my eyes are falling. They're hooding above my eyes. So presenting with heavy eyelids or hooding above the eyes or tired eyes is probably the second or third most common reason that people come into clinics, something around the eye, because it ages first. The skin is thin underneath. Some people get bags below the eyes, but the hooding above the eyes is a particular problem, and a lot of people don't want to have surgery. So right off the top, let's get that and put that aside. If people have a lot of skin, there's redundant skin, and it's heavy enough, especially if the skin's resting on the lashes, that's a good way to tell. Certainly surgery is a great option for a lot of people, and I often tell people to get it sometimes a little younger than waiting till they're older, because it's a treatment they're probably going to get if they have lax skin, and a lot of people really like the results if it's done properly. And then it allows us to do the minimally invasive treatments and even use neuromodulators such as Botox and Dysport in the forehead without that all important worry of lowering of the eyes, because everyone thinks you get a brow lift from treating the forehead with neuromodulators, but you actually get a drop. So what can we do if A, they don't want to do surgery, or they're not quite yet a surgical candidate? Well, there's aging in the upper face that we can address. First of all, if there's temporal hollowing, by filling the temporal region, we get a lift. And you can even treat into the hairline to get a lift back. And typically we're using Sculptor in my clinic for this for several reasons, but it's a safer product, it's longer lasting, it waters the carrier so we can pull back on the syringe, and we do it at a level that's safer. And remember, the less you have to inject a temple, the safer it is. The more you have to come back for repeat injections, the more dangerous in a sense it can become too. So we factor that in. So there's the temple hollow. Next, we'll talk about fillers, because you can also use, and my choice would be hyaluronic acid fillers, at or above the brow region to create lift, because not only do people lose projection of the brow, there's volume in the forehead region that they lose, and we're not filling, the forehead to fill is a somewhat more dangerous area, so that's another video. I'm talking about at the brow, and I will almost always use a 25 gauge cannula for that. Be mindful, there's that supraocular artery as well to avoid. So that's filler in that region. Everyone wants to fill the under eye, but the upper eye looks great with filler. Next, I often add at the same visit some PDO threads. Just putting smooth threads in, it's amazing how much lift you get if you have some patience and you repeat it at 2 months. You can use barb threads. Now, there's not a lot of fat in the forehead, so it's a tender procedure. A lot of people don't like that, the part that you have to use some more anesthesia for it. And it works very well, but you can get asymmetry from one side to the other because of the way the barbs work. But it is a good solution for some people, so it can be used. Next in line is neuromodulators such as Botox and Dysport. Now, treating the depressor complex such as the glabella, and then treating the downward fibers of the orbicularis oculi muscle that encircles the eye, all creates lift. But avoid the forehead, because if you treat the forehead, the only thing that can happen is you can lower. I know everyone wants a smooth forehead, but it comes with that price, is that it does not create lift, but quite the opposite. So radio frequency devices, ultrasound heating devices can also work to varying degrees, but for the money that most people pay for the amount of long-term lift they get, may or may not be worth it for their while. Things like platelet-rich fibrin don't work great for lift. There's not enough power. And other procedures might have a short-term effect, like peels, make the skin better, make it glow, but don't really create a lot of lift. So thanks for joining me today. I'd love to hear your experience and favorite treatments for hooded eyes. There's space below on this YouTube channel. Also join us on Instagram and subscribe here, and also click the notification bell to get updated on our latest videos that we put out twice each week.